incredible whore. I spit when I talk. I fuck anything that walks. Come here, I used to get so hungry, I would throw fits. How you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits.
Yeah.
I lay it with
man. What's good, YouTube? Welcome back to Benefit and welcome back to the channel, man. So, man, I see who we got back here in the building. It is Eminem. We are finally starting on the next album, which is titled The Slim Shady LP. Now, here's the thing, right? If you guys are, like, new to this journey and everything, guys, I am literally going down the whole entire Eminem catalog. Literally going down the whole entire, full entire thing, bro, you know? So, we just got done checking out his Infinite album. I will put the annotation to the playlist that is right up there. At least I hope so. Please don't let me forget. Now, this album did drop right after the Infinite album. This is literally 1999. This was whenever he was signed to a record, because I said this, they said that this album is through Interscope. I looked it up on the internet. No, it's Aftermath. Well, Aftermath / Interscope. So, yeah, this was whenever he... So, I guess he just got signed right after the Infinite album. At least I'm thinking. Came out in 1999. I wasn't even born yet. I wasn't even born yet, and this man was making music. So, and I'm 20 now. I'm 20. I wasn't even born yet. You know, I was a little nutball. You know what, man? Hey, we're going to get straight into this thing, man. We are going to check out three songs. Well, three technically, because first one is real, real short public service announcement. And then we got My Name Is, and then Guilty Conscience. So, hey, we finna go ahead and get straight to this thing, but if you guys are new to the channel, though, hey, consider that subscribe button down below. I know we're at 25,000 subscribers. Other than that, hey, let's check this thing out, bruh.
Announcement brought to you in part by Slim Shady. The views and events expressed here are totally fucked and are not necessarily the views of anyone. However, the events and suggestions that appear on this album are not to be taken lightly. Children should not partake in the listening of this album. This is in their shoes. Slim Shady is not responsible for your actions. Upon purchasing this album, you have agreed not to try this at home. Anything else?
Yeah. Don't do drugs.
Hi, my name is... See, bro, one thing I do gotta say, bro, I love when they make albums meant to just not shuffle. You know what I mean by that is the public service announcement went through and then it literally boom stopped, branched into my, and he literally goes, just one other thing, boop, my name is, that's hot, bro. It's like a way of like smooth transition into the next song, bro. Make people feel you for sure. Turn me up though. Let me hear this song.
Of the class. My name for one second.
My name is Hi kids, do you like violence?
Yeah,
wanna
yeah,
see
yeah.
Me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids? Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did?
Yeah,
try
yeah.
Sit and get fucked up worse than my life is? My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I wanna impregnate. Dr. Dre said.
Now, bro, my thing is he trying to show that kids get hooked on to what influencers do right in this scene? Like, do you want to see me stick a 9-inch nail through my eyelid or something like that? And is he trying to show like that people be copying influencers? Like, well, like these influencers are like a big movement and based on what these younger generations do today. But this was in 1999, so I wasn't even born. But still, though, it kind of applies today, though.
You a basic. Watch your face red, man, you wasted.
Well, since age 12, I felt like I'm someone else, cause I hung my original self from the top bunk with a belt. Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked it so hard I knocked the clothes backwards like Chris Paul.
Whoa!
Original self from the top bunk with a belt. Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off and smacked it so hard I knocked the clothes backwards like Chris Paul. Fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. Shady, wait a minute. Whoa, now. Hold up, bro. Let me think of that moment right there. Hello, bro. Hard, I knock the clothes backwards like Chris Paul. I smoke a fat pound of grass and fall on my ass faster than a fat bitch who sat down too fast. Bro, he not lying, bro. Like, bro, they do be doing. Like, you know, if you got excessive weight, you know, you got excessive weight. Don't come after me. But then, too, you need to get that excessive weight off of you because it's not good for your health. Anyway, so it's true, though, because it's like they sit in a chair. They literally go like this. They sit down hard. Boom. Chair fall back. I know what he means, bro. That's a way of putting it in a scene. Shady, wait a minute. That's my girl, dog. I don't give a fuck. God sent me to piss the world off.
Wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester I'll be 35. Smacked him in his face.
Whoa, what, bruh? Hello, bruh. That didn't make too much sense. Go back.
English teacher wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester I'll be 35.
What do you mean by that? Like, how does that apply? What? Oh, bro. He's saying flunk. Like, flunk. Okay, flunk is a way of saying they're trying to fail you. Flunk is a way of saying people will be like, oh, I flunked fourth grade. That means that they failed fourth grade. So he said next semester he'll be 35. Huh? I get what he's saying with the flunk, though, but what do you mean by that, though? How am I not getting this? How am I not getting this, bro?
Teacher wanted to flunk me in junior high. Thanks a lot. Next semester I'll be 35. I smacked him in his face with an eraser. Chased him with a stapler. Stapled his nuts to a stack of paper. In the strip club, had my jacket zipped up. Flashed the bartender and stuck my dick in a tip cup. Extraterrestrial, running over pedestrians in a spaceship while they screaming at me. Let's just be free. 99% of my life I was lied to. I just found out my mom does more dope than I do. I told her I'd grow up to be a famous rapper. Make a record about doing drugs and name it after. You know you blew up when the women rush your stands. Try to touch your hands like some screaming Usher fans. Sky White Castle asked for my autograph, so I signed it. Dear Dave, thanks for the support, asshole.
And see, bro, this was like his debut for real album. So Infinite was his first. This was his debut. I'm sure when they heard this, they went crazy. It was probably something new to the scene. You know, y'all see, this is literally the most played album on this thing. Literally the most played. So it's like, you know, he debuted in this thing, bro, and they probably ain't never seen a flow like it, bro. I don't recall nobody sounding like this way back then. I wasn't born, but come on now, let's be real. Like, when I go back through the catalogs of old, you know, rap and stuff like that, you don't hear anybody like sounding like this. So it was like something new to the scene. Everybody hopped on it.
Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away. Get it, Dre. Don't just stand there. Operate. I'm ready to leave. It's too scary to die. I'll have to be carried inside the cemetery and buried alive. Am I coming or going? I can barely decide. I just drank a fifth of vodka. Dare me to drive? All my life I was very deprived. I ain't had a woman in years. My palms are too hairy to hide. Clothes ripped like the Incredible Hulk. I spit when I talk. I fuck anything that walks. Come here, I used to get so hungry I would throw fits. How you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits.
Yeah. Man, whoa, bro, that man, bro, it was, bro, this was something new to the scene, bro. This is why this song did crazy like it. This was something new, bro. Ain't nobody was rapping like this back in the day. I'm telling you, they wasn't, bro. Like, this was something new. Everybody was like, what, dude, what is this guy doing? You know?
Clothes ripped like the Incredible Hulk. I spit when I talk.
I fuck anything that walks. When I was little, I used to get so hungry, I would throw fits. How you gonna breastfeed me, mom? You ain't got no tits.
That's violating, bro.
In the bed with a bulletproof vest on and shoot myself in the head. Bang. Steaming mad. And by the way, when you see my dad, yeah, tell him that I slit his throat in this dream I had. My name is
Bro, I'm liking this song, bro. This is like, bro, I'm liking it, bro. What's the rest? I may just let the beat ride out. Yeah, bro, like, I'm telling you, bro, like, this is, bro, I'm telling you right now, you don't recall, at least me, I don't recall nobody sounding like this back in that era, back in this era of music. I ain't know nobody who sounded like this. Now, I know I did have a comment that said, like, back in the day, they said Eminem sounded too close to, Nas and somebody else. So they said, like, he had to come up with a way of sounding different or whatnot, bro. But, like, bro, this, I'm sure this song blew up. This song went crazy. 1999. Godly, that's some time ago. I'm 20 now. And I turned 21 next month. By the time y'all seen this one, though, this video might be going out in June. So, you know. Dang. This song's a banger, though. And y'all see what's crazy? It's like, I don't know. I mean, I ain't going to judge the next song, but probably all them plays transfer to the next song because this song is literally the one right after it. So people let it just transition through. But hey, let's check out the next song, bro. This is Guilty Conscience, Eminem featuring Dr. Dre. So let's see this one. I ain't never heard this one. Let's check it out, though.
Meet Eddie, 23 years old. Fed up with life and the way things are going, he decides to rob a liquor store. But on his way in, he has a sudden change of heart, and suddenly, his conscience comes into play.
All right, stop. Now before you walk in the door of this liquor store and try to get money out the drawer, you better think of the consequence.
Well, who are you?
I'm your motherfucking conscience.
That's nonsense. Go in, gap all the money, and run to one of your aunt's cribs, and borrow a damn dress, the one of a blonde wig, telling you need a place.
I get what they're doing. They saying this, bro. They are literally doing this song in the terms of your mind talking to you. Oh, John, that's why it's called Guilty Conscience, cause.
Yeah, for the money you run to one of your aunt's cribs and borrow a damn dress, the one of a blonde wig. Telling you need a place to stay. You'll be safe for days if you shave your legs with Renee's razor blades.
If it all goes through like it's supposed to, the whole neighborhood knows you and they'll expose you. Think about it before you walk in the door first. Look at the store clerk, she's older than George Burns.
Fuck that, do that shit, shoot that bitch. Can you afford to blow this shit? Are you that rich? Why you give a fuck if she dies? Are you that bitch? Do you really think she gets the fuck if you have kids?
Man, don't do it, it's not worth it to risk it.
Right.
Not over this shit.
Stop.
Drop the biscuit. Don't even listen to Slim, yo, he's bad for you.
You know what, Dre? I don't like your attitude.
Oh, they switching it up, bro? Sign in the club.
Stan, 21 years old. After meeting a young girl at a rave party, things start getting hot. And
they say it's Stan.
Upstairs bedroom. Once again, his conscience comes into play.
Now listen to me.
Bro, you telling me that Eminem put it together to where this Stan character was literally introduced and this scene right here was literally introducing this scene. Now Stan isn't on this album, is it? No, it's not. Whoa, bro. Dang, bro. That's putting two and two together. So Stan was introduced in this album right here? It's crazy. It's crazy.
While you're kissing her cheek and smearing her lipstick, slip this in a dream. Now all you gotta do is nibble on this little bitch's earlobe.
So, this girl's only 15 years old. You shouldn't take it.
He laced her drink. But they're speaking in her conscience. They're speaking in the bro, this is a unique song, bro.
That's not fair.
Yo, look at her bush.
doesn't got hair. Fuck this bitch right here on the spot bare. Till she passes out, she forgot how she got there.
Man, ain't you ever seen that one movie, Kids?
No, but I seen the porno with Son Nubian.
What, bruh? What?
You ever seen that one movie, Kids?
No, but I seen the porno with Son Nubian.
Shit, you wanna get hard off the jail?
Man, fuck that. Hit that shit raw dog and bell.
Dang, bruh. They talking crazy in this one, bruh. No filter.
Meet Grady, a 29-year-old construction worker. After coming home from a hard day's work, he walks in the door of his trailer park home to find his wife in bed with another man.
What the fuck? Hey, alright, calm down, relax, and start breathing.
Fuck that shit, you just caught this bitch cheating. While you at work, she's with some dude trying to get off. Fuck, slit in her throat, cut this bitch's head off.
What if there's an explanation for this shit?
What?
Bro, I'm telling you right now, bro, they know what they were doing when they made this song, bro. You know, and it's crazy because it's like, if we being completely real here, nobody was doing stuff like this. And you know, obviously now with how the world is super weak nowadays, bro. If they released this today, they would have probably got mid-canceled. But you can't cancel Eminem. He's too high up. You can't cancel Dr. Dre. He's too much of an OG. You just can't do that. But they would have tried to find some way. Oh my God, we're gonna boycott listening to Eminem type junk like that. You can't. No, bro. Why is people nowadays super weak now? You can't say nothing. Seriously, bro. This is very unique how they made this song. Literally speaking in terms of a conscience, bro. I like how they did this.
You get all crazy.
Okay, thought about it. Still wanna stab her. Grab her by the throat. Get your daughter and kidnap her. That's what I did. Be smart. Don't be a retard. You gonna take advice from somebody who slapped D Barnes?
What you say?
What's wrong? Didn't think I remember?
I'ma kill you, motherfucker.
Temper. Mr. Dre, Mr. N.W.A., Mr. A.K., coming straight out of Compton, y'all better make way. You gonna tell this man not to be violent?
Cause he don't need to go the same route that I went. Been there, done that. Oh, fuck it, what am I saying? Shoot them both, Grady, where's your gun at?
Bro, they did a well done job doing this song, bro. Well done, bro. This was like, as far as like production wise on this song, bro, they did a fantastic job. You know, there ain't no meat ride, there ain't none of that. It's just like, who was making stuff like this back in the day? Not really too many people. Like, just a thought. I mean, you spoke in terms of literally your conscience, bro. Like, literally rapped in terms of your conscience. I thought it was dope, though. I feel like this was dope, man. And what's crazy, it's like, these are like the top most played songs on the album. Like, other than that, I mean, the views just kind of weakening out. I mean, Role Model has close to 100 million plays, but yeah, man, I don't know. We're just gonna be going down this album. A lot of these are skits, so might have to triple up on the things, but I don't think I'm gonna put like public service announcement, you know, just like the short, the 10 second, 15, the skits and stuff. I'm not gonna put those in the title because those take up space for me to put my meaning of what I thought, but yeah, man. So, anyways, hey, both of those songs are bangers, bro. My name is Slim Shady, and I think I want to say that I had my name is Eminem. Didn't get a music video to this 12 years ago. We gotta check that out. Man. Anyways, man, hey, there you guys have it for the entire reaction, man. Hey, hope you guys did enjoy. We'll see you guys in the next one, man. But if you guys did enjoy, hey, make sure you guys hit the like button down below. Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below as well. I know we're at 25,000 subscribers. That though, hey, it's people of quality care. Care about to stay. Peace out. Love you guys.